because I love him for who he is. He loves me for who I am. And who I am is a whopper eating fat ass.
It's Liam Mouse Vlog, Liam Mouse Vlog, it's Liam Mouse's Vlog.
Well, hey, oh, howdy doody again, folks. I'm looking for my little, there it is. I found it. Now you can come in the car with me. So it's candle day. I'm finished because I started early, you know. So it wasn't as many as last time, thank goodness, but yeah, they're done. JJ just texted me. Oh my God. I feel like all my vlogs are the same. Me talking about candles and showing the cat. JJ's having a really long day at work and he asked me if I had time to go shopping and I'm like, as it happens, I just poured the last candle, so yes I do. So we have to go get a few things for him. And it works out perfectly because I'm hungry and I was sitting here trying to figure out what in the heck to do about it because I don't feel like cooking anything. So I was like, well, if I could just grab some food, that'd be perfect. So guess what? I'm going out, so I'm gonna grab some food. Scrappy's gonna come with me. Yes. Yes, you're gonna come with Mama. Are you excited? Yes. He always knows. He's so smart. Yes, you're gonna come with Mama. Yes, you excited? You wanna come shopping with me? You wanna go shopping? Okay, we'll go shopping. I feel like vlogging today. I know y'all are like getting a treat because you just got two vlogs from like when Mom was here and everything. Hold on, hold on. Pardon. But yeah, I actually have time for a second and we're doing some stuff today. Oh, where's my doodle? Okay, I got it. All right. All right, we're gonna go shopping. Yes, we're gonna go shopping. We're gonna go shopping. Are you excited? Yes. I trust you to make it to the car on your own because you're a good boy.
Yes, you're a good boy. Yes, you're excited? Let's go shopping. Good boy.
All right, dude, we're probably gonna run out of battery. Yeah, I never charged the battery after Mom left because I was like, well, I'm not gonna vlog again for a while, whatever. I'm dumb. Oh, it's too hot for a fall day right now. It's very irritating. Pleasant sound.
Shh. Sorry, Scrappy, I know. I know, dear.
Alright, where the hell is the drive-thru for this damn thing? Oh. Yeah, okay. Of course you're standing outside staring at me. Why wouldn't you be?
You want something? You want some chicken nuggets? Did you want some chicken nuggets? What do you think?
Thank you for stopping. I'll be right with you.
Scrappy, you want some cheesy tots?
Thank you for stopping at Burger King. How can I help you?
I'll take a number one with a Sprite, please.
What size?
Well, small.
Small? All right. And you said Sprite?
Yep.
All right. Anything else?
Nope, that's all.
All right. Your total today is 9:45.
All right. Thank you. I was not prepared for that question.
Scrappy, this might be complicated with you sitting right here on my lap like this.
Don't toss your receipt. Get a free Whopper sandwich with purchase and validation code by taking a short survey. What do you think? Do you want to get a free Whopper? We don't eat this very often, do we? We probably shouldn't be eating it now, but it's yummy and that's what Mama wants. Nice
meeting. 9:45. Hi, Bobby.
Thank you.
All right, Scrappy, you gonna guard the food for me? Yes, you guard the food. Yes, we gotta pull up just a little bit so that Mama can put this in the back.
If I can reach it. Ah, screw it, I'll just hold it. Why not?
I don't have room in my cup holder.
While I'm waiting. There we go.
Situation resolved.
Oh, stop it, car.
Oh my God, what is wrong with my car?
Oh, this is an old one. Does your chewing gum lose its flavor on the bedpost overnight? If your mama says don't chew it, do you swallow it in spite? Can you catch it on your tonsils and heave it left and right? Does your chewing gum lose its flavor on the bedpost overnight?
Yeah, strong. Whopper. And fries. Are we doing a mukbang part two? Well, if you're offended by watching me eat a Whopper, look away now. It's been too long. I don't normally eat fast food. I prefer not to. But damn, I loves me some Whopper. The stuff I had to go shopping for JJ for was for this cabbage soup diet that he's on. You know, I really commend him for being healthy and wanted to take care of himself. And I think that's super awesome. I respect him for that. I admire that. But I have no guilt in stuffing my face with a Whopper in lieu of his cabbage soup diet. Because I love him for who he is. He loves me for who I am. And who I am is a Whopper eating fat ass. We actually talked about this last night, and I told him how cool it was that he's doing this. And he takes really good care of himself. Like, he eats really well, takes his supplements, makes sure he gets a lot of protein, he exercises. And I'm like, you know, I think that's really cool, and I see no problem with it whatsoever. I love you either way. I don't care if you're 300 pounds of muscle, 300 pounds of fat. You're you to me. Doesn't make a difference. I said, while I respect you for doing that, I'm gonna keep eating cookies, cake, and Whoppers. I don't mind being a little bit chubby, and who I am as a person, I would not be happy exercising and eating things like cabbage soup or whatever. And that has nothing to do with who I am and how I feel about myself. You know, I'd rather be a little bit chubby and be happy than be in great shape and be like, but this isn't really who I am, and this has no bearing on anything. You know, it really doesn't. I mean, I'm not obese. I'm certainly not obese. I make sure to keep it that way. And I would never intentionally let myself become obese or unhealthily overweight or whatever. I also don't need to have a perfect gym bod or a perfect swimsuit bod or whatever, because I don't care. It has nothing to do with my brain and who I am, and he loves me for that. And he said the same thing. He's like, yeah, I don't care. So, it's all good. I'm gonna eat the rest of this and not force you to indulge.
Well, we had to switch to the phone because my battery and my camera died. Like I said, I didn't charge it. Didn't charge it like I should have, but here we are. I don't know why I'm talking like that. You know me by now. I do weird shit. I have made a recent resolution that Houdini supports and approves of.
Yes, Houdini supports Mama's decision.
Okay, so I decided I'm gonna take better care of my hair, cause like, I have a job where I mean, I literally wear my hair up all the time. I mean, all the time, because for work, it's out of my way and everything. When I'm making my candles, same thing. I don't wanna get hair all over the place. When I'm just relaxing, it's up, like right now, like it just, it's annoying and I don't take care of it. You know, it's dry, it's kind of damaged, and it, you know, is sorely in need of some color touch-up. I never style it anymore. I don't ever, like, showcase my hair. So I decided to make a conscious effort to take better care of my hair so that I can just, I don't know, not feel like a grungy hobo sponge all the time. I don't know. I got some products yesterday. I went shopping a little bit here. Got some hair dye, which we are going to use right now. About to use. This is stuff I had. I got this though. I picked this up, this argan oil spray, misting spray for hydration and things. I got the set of curling irons because, I mean, I have that sapphire curling wand thing, but it's so annoying. I mean, it works well, but it's annoying because you have to, like, manually wrap the hair and then hold it with that weight, with that heat-resistant glove. And it's annoying, and I'd rather just be able to take a curling iron and go, you know, clamp it and just stand there and, like, wait. I don't know, having one hand free, you know what I mean? It just seemed easier. So I found this set. This was only $16 for three different curling irons, you know, of three different sizes, you know, and it's Conair, which is, you know, usually pretty good. I was like, why not, right? I'm not going to use them probably that much to wear them out that quickly, so I figured it would be a good buy for me. And I also got this Tresemme heat protectant spray so that when I do style my hair or blow dry my hair or whatever, it'll be protected, you know, from damage and everything like that. So I'm going to dye my hair. I know I started doing the half black, half purple thing, but my God, I just don't have the time or energy to keep up with the crazy high maintenance hair thing anymore. I just don't. So we're just gonna go back to black because it's simple, it's quick, and it'll work. And I like it. I don't mind having all black hair. It's fine, it suits me. It's all good. So I'm not gonna make you sit through that process because I don't wanna try to juggle a phone and do this at the same time. I just wanna watch my Teen Mom 2 on Paramount Plus, zone out, do my hair, and get her done. Baby's calling me, excuse me. So just for reference, this is what we're starting with. Boy, that's nasty. So this is what we're starting with.
It's happening. Hey, cause I'm back in black! Cause I'm back in black!
Welcome to the next day. I'm sitting here at work on my little breaky break thing, and I just have my little meat and cheese cup with my fruit and my crackers and stuff. Oh my God. I'm super happy that I dyed my hair because my God, it was looking so... I just was not proud of my hair. And you know me and my hair. I've always been like with the hair, you know what I mean? So I actually was able to curl it this morning. Excuse my blub, this is my whopper belly, you all know. It didn't like curl like super curly, but I mean it looks nicer than just like, you know what I mean? I was able to do it, ooh, I missed a couple spots, whatever. I was able to do it with the curling irons that I bought, you know, the one, and it was nice because I was like, do I have enough time to do this before work? I don't know. So what I would do is I just like went down with the curling iron, wrapped it up, and I just held it with my left hand, and then I was like starting to do my makeup with my right hand. I would do like one color, like one swoosh, and then I'd put the brush down, like undo the curl, wrap up the next curl, hold it there, do the next bit, you know. So I was like simultaneously doing my makeup and my hair, which is awesome because I'm a multitasker to the max, and anything that I can multitask, I will do it. And I love to do it, and it feels great. So it really only took me maybe 5 to 10 more minutes, if that, you know, total, just because I had to like toggle back and forth between. But yeah, knowing that I can do that now makes me feel better. I will sleep very well tonight knowing that I can actually properly take care of my hair, make it look nice, and have time, you know, not waste any more time on it. You know what I mean? I know it seems really weird and maybe a little bit vain, but to me, it's not about the vanity thing. It's just I've always felt good when my hair is good, you know? Like, JJ's taking really good care of himself right now, like, his body. Like, oh my God, he's exercising. He did a bunch of pull-ups yesterday. I thought he was gonna, like, explode something out of his head. He was just, you know, and, like, doing that. Like, this guy's muscles are so huge. Just kind of getting ridiculous at this point. But, you know, he's taking real good care of himself and his body, and while that is awesome, I mean, we covered this earlier while I was eating the Whopper, that's not what I would take pride in. I take pride in my hair. It's my hair. So if I take good care of my hair care, then that's what makes me feel good and positive and everything. So he's doing something that's actually admirable and will matter later in life, whereas I'm, you know, with the hair. But that's okay. We all have our stuff, right? I'm enjoying this. My hair always looks so crappy, like, at the roots, which is why I'm filming it, so that it's like, you can't see that part. Because right after I dye it, it gets, you know, maybe some of you guys who dye your own hair, you know this, you understand. But at the roots, it looks really weird, because, like, the dye just kind of sits there, and you can't really scrub it out. It doesn't really come off until the first wash. But it, like, yeah, it looks, like solid, so it almost looks like a wig, you know what I mean? So I'm just showing the flattering part right now, and plus I have a big old forehead, so we don't need the cinematic scope of the 6, 7, 8, 9 head, whatever I've got going on here. So, you know, I'm much more attractive from the eyebrows to the chin, and we'll just keep it that way for now. Oh man, so I wish I could tell you about this work situation. Oh my god, some stuff went down at work, and I wish I could tell you. Oh god, I wish I could tell you, but I definitely can't, because it could get me in trouble, and I don't want to do that, and it could get other people in trouble, and I definitely don't want to do that. But let's just say there is a situation at work with, to put it bluntly, there's a bully at work, and people have been dealing with this situation for a while, long before I came along. I was actually warned about it before I started, and I was like, whatever, okay. So I actually had to come up against it yesterday when I was at work, and it was a situation where it went beyond bullying and into, yeah, I'm pretty sure you can't do that. So like, you know, it was like kind of, I can't get into it. I wish I could explain it. It would make more sense. But it went beyond bullying into like trying to get around a policy that their company actually has by making like a sort of a blackmail threat, essentially. You know, and that's why I was like, I don't think you can do that. Like, you're just throwing your weight around at this point, and you're on like a weird power trip. So I called, I'll just say I made a phone call, and it was resolved in a couple of hours. Now they're mad at me, and they're being really petty about it, but I resolved the situation myself, you know, obviously with the help of the person that I called. My people are all very happy that I took care of it. I don't know why nobody did up until this point, but I guess maybe it wasn't until it came to this exact situation that anybody could do anything about it. But I did. I took the matter in my hands, and I'm like, okay, look, I'm a squeaky wheel. Okay. I'm sorry. I can deal with your bullying crap all day. I've dealt with bullies my entire life. It doesn't faze me. You can act however you want. But when it comes down to a policy violation and like a threat and like sort of like a blackmail thing, I'm like, this isn't right. This isn't right. So my phone call took care of it, and everybody is happy that I did that, except for obviously the people who got in trouble because of my phone call. So now they're being petty and stupid about it, but they can be petty and stupid. I don't care. The situation, the specific situation that was the problem, got resolved, and that's all I care about. So they can behave like children as long as they want. So I needed to tell you, somebody, anything. So I stuck to my guns, and it was good, and everybody is happy except for the bullies, but screw them, right? Haha. I'm gonna get back to work now and take one more sip of my boo. Happy National Coffee Day, by the way. I will see y'all later. Thanks for hanging out with me. Good vibes to all. Watch out for the sheep. Vlog phrase of the day is, don't let the bullies get you down. I think that's a good phrase. We can all live by it every day, right? Okay, bye!